Hey, what's up there, fellow rock stars? Ben Littlefield here, rock star Ben, and I have got our good friend, our man, Dr. Dan, with us. Dr. Dan, say hello.
What up, fellow rock stars?
Awesome, awesome guys. Well, we've got some really cool special guests with us today. We'll introduce them in just a moment. I'll let Dr. Dan introduce them. But real quick, let's do a quick sound check. Everybody hear me? Everybody hear Dan all right? Just type in yes in the chat box if you hear us just fine.
Cool. We'll get some checks there. Loud cool. And clear.
Man, people from all over the world on this thing. That's very cool. Love it. Love it. Sweet. All right. So, guys, what we're doing today is we've got a couple of special guests with us. We got our good friend Ollie G and Ryan Shaw, who, like I said, will let Dan officially introduce in a moment. But look, what we're about today is we're going to try to go through a really condensed and very easy to follow strategy and show you some cool stuff, how Facebook is really, you know, finally reaching that tipping point. It's finally ticked to where it makes sense in an offline world. It makes sense in what we do in local marketing or any kind of marketing we're doing where we're working with other clients or digital assets. Some of you might be familiar with our Facebook landlord method that, you know, we spent quite a bit of time developing and making that system work for us. And, you know, that was out of a big need for us to tap into, you know, all that amazing targeted traffic and all that amazing targeted money that was just sitting there in Facebook that, you know, before just was very frustrating to deal with. So what we want, you know, to do today is show you something really cool that you can walk away with and have some new ideas and be able to keep growing your rockstar business. Sound good? Awesome. Dan, why don't you say hello for a moment and introduce our amazing guests.
Awesome. Hello again. It's me, Dr. Dan. Yeah, we got some really, really awesome guys here. Is this being taped? I don't think so, Dan, because we don't really use cassette tapes anymore. But we are going to record this. So we're going to be putting this on 8-track. And then from there, we're going to go ahead and I'm just kidding, guys. I'm just teasing.
Put it out on vinyl.
Yeah, we're going to put it on vinyl. But no, we've really got a great webinar for you guys. As you can see right there on the slides, let me go full screen on my thing right here too. We've actually got Ali G on the line here, and we've also got Ryan, as we call him, Ryan F. and Shaw. And we might reveal later on, if you stick around for the end roll credits, we might reveal why he got that nickname, Ryan F. and Shaw. And Ali G too. I mean, great guys. Seriously, these guys have been doing this for quite a while now. We've known these guys for a couple years. Both of them are just like killing it. They're crushing it. They're making it happen. They're not guys that are just creating products left and right and not making any money in their business themselves. These guys are actually using the tools and the strategies that they reveal with you guys, and they're making money with it. And that's what I really respect and love about these guys. I really love just hanging out with Ali G. He's a great guy. Ben. I got a chance to finally hang out a little longer with him at the last event we were at. And he was telling me, he's like, man, I finally got to really hang out with Ali G. I really like that guy. And I'm like, you know, that's good. I'm glad because I really enjoy hanging out with him too when he's not drunk. Just kidding. No, but these guys are seriously, they're really great guys. We really love them. And I can't really say enough good stuff about them. So that's my intro for you guys.
Hey, I appreciate that, Dan. We had a killer training here. I have a couple of questions to ask the audience before we begin. And just to take a poll of everybody, first question is, who wants more leads for their offline business? Just put a yes into your chat box if you want more leads. Yes, I see a few yeses coming in through.
A bunch of yeses, hell yeah, hell yes.
Who doesn't want more leads, right? Yeah, that's my strategy.
I don't want any leads.
That's my strategy. How can I get more leads for my business coming in every single day? How can I scale up, get more leads? So maybe I want to walk away from a few clients that aren't paying me as well, or you know what? These guys are really a pain in the neck. I'm going to drop these guys because now I have new leads coming in. They're going to be offering me even more money. And if with that power becomes a huge business where you can spend less time working on it, and having more money come in at the same time. And that's how I scaled my business, my offline business especially, where I have a full list of 20 clients where I'm not even taking any more clients right now, as I'm really happy with the clients I have. They pay me really well. And it's because of that, I went through a few clients. They're like, well, they're okay. It's great for starting up. Perhaps you have some clients, too, that aren't paying you as well. Perhaps you're feeling like you're doing too much work. Or maybe you're just trying to get your first clients. It looks like we got over 50, maybe even 75 yeses. So I know everyone here is excited to learn how to get some more leads for their offline business. And Ali G and myself have been using Facebook for over a year now to do this. We have some really cool tactics to share with you and some really exciting software that we're going to be demoing in a little while. So you want to stick around for this. So if you have any distractions in the background, make sure to mute your phone. You got social media in the background. Maybe you have Facebook up. Well, we can take a look at that later. We're going to really show you a few nice screenshots. So we're going to plug and play, and you can walk away with something real, something really beneficial for your business. And my goal for you is to help you start making profits from Facebook after today. And I'll show you why Facebook is important in our industry now and what's changed over just the past 18 months. So maybe you're tired of the following things. I know I've tried it all. So if you've been in offline for some time, you know you have to do a lot of work to get a client. It's not always as easy as we like. You know, Dr. Dan and Ben, they have these amazing products to help us along. I remember getting my first copy of Google Love Method, one of the top products I've ever seen on the Warrior Forum. I'm sure many of you have that as well. And some of the strategies are just really killer in there, right? So what we're going to show you is something a little bit different, so you can use anything that you've learned in the past, but now phase it in with an additional strategy, and that's Facebook. So perhaps you've tried some of the things in the past, such as SEO, press releases, article marketing, running AdWords, cold calling, networking events, going online and just spamming people, sending out emails, doing newspaper advertisements, knocking on doors, posting on Craigslist. I've done all of these methods. I've done so many past this. I've tried them all. I've tested them all. What works for best for offline? And what really stood out to me is how can I get more leads without spending a lot of money and without spending a lot of my own time? And so I work with a lot of coaching students privately as well, helping their offline businesses. So we've tested out some things, and we're going to show you the results here. Now, usually, I got to be honest, some of this information I've never shared outside to the public, outside of my own coaching students. So you're in for a really special treat. You stay to the end. All right, so now we got to prove to you why you need to use Facebook to get more leads for your offline business, right, your local business. And again, this doesn't have to be offline, but we're going to focus in as, you know, many of you here are in the offline space. But no matter what product or service, Facebook is leading the way right now. And, as you can see right here, you can get in front of more people with Facebook than any other platform on the Internet. And this has been going on for quite a while. So this is an older map here. This is only goes back to March 2011. As you can see, Facebook overtook Google pretty quickly once it started ramping up in 07, 08, 09. And what this means basically is that people spend an average of about 35 minutes a day on Facebook currently, which I've read. So that means they're spending more time on Facebook than pretty much every other site, right? Even combined. Take a look at this graph right here. So this shows, again, U.S. share of time spent online. As you can see, Facebook is just destroying anybody else. And finally, if this doesn't do it for you, I don't know what will. Perhaps you've tried to get clients using different online media platforms, Craigslist, LinkedIn, Twitter, right? It doesn't even compare. Just check this out. This is mind-boggling. 53 billion minutes per month are spent on Facebook, and then there's everything else, which doesn't even hold a candle to it. So we're going to show you in a second how you can locate and find business owners on Facebook really easily with literally just 5 seconds typing in on your keyboard. We're going to show you how you can find hundreds of qualified leads for your business. And then we're going to show you the easy way of doing it and the automated way. So who wants to do it manually, right? Well, we're going to show you that way first so you can learn about this. But then we're going to show you where the magic comes in and where you can completely automate your Facebook marketing without doing a thing. Just go about your day and then wait for business owners to call you. So hopefully that sounds great to everybody. We're going to show you some ways right now. Oh, we're seeing a few comments in the chat box saying I'm excited. Definitely like to speak with you guys further on this. Awesome. So the first thing I wanted to show you is that you can contact with Open Graph anybody on Facebook. But specifically, if we're looking for leads, well, we want to look to find out who we want to search for, right? We want to search for business owners, perhaps in our area. I'm living in New Jersey, so what I would want to do is I want to do a search for, say, my hometowns, local cities, and then I can type in things like business owners who live in New Jersey, and then I have a whole list that I can contact, that I can message, add as friends, start networking with Facebook. And like I said, this is the manual way. And what you don't want to do here is you don't want to spam them and send them messages right away, because your message will go into the other folder on Facebook, which is essentially your spam folder on a traditional email service. So what you want to do is you want to build relationships with these. Perhaps you can find out if they're in different groups. So we'll show you this in a second. There's a whole lot you can do with the Open Graph technology, and they are still increasing the possibilities with this right now. Facebook has even come out saying that Open Graph is going to be one of its main features going forward. So they've created like a search engine, but for people. And guess what? Because all that, the data that I showed you earlier, everybody is on Facebook. You can literally find eight-figure earners within a click of a mouse. Hey, we can even find Dan in the click of a mouse here. So we'll see how we can do that in a second. So here's lawyers who live in San Diego, California. Here's another example. So it doesn't really matter for, say, like what or who you're trying to contact. You can get to them on Facebook rather than anywhere else on the internet. So it's really has become the largest database available of people. And you know, Facebook's going to be utilizing this for their advertising technology. So you can contact lawyers, doctors, chiropractors, restaurant owners, independent contractors, salespeople, real estate, you name it, you can contact them with a simple search, and then you can provide even more of a detailed search with refining it. So you can refine male, female, gender, where they're from, current city, employment location, how long they've been working there, and really, really focus down and finding high quality leads. Now, usually what you'd have to do is you actually have to go out, find a lead list, you know, you use like some kind of email tool or scraper tool so you can get a list of leads, or go onto Google and go through Google Plus or Yelp, get a database or buy a list, right? And then you'd have to call them yourself and go through a gatekeeper, or perhaps you have a salesperson that you're paying, right, on commissions, or even, you know, I've done all of these things. But what happens is there's a big bottleneck. You know, people can't be reached on the phone anymore. It's crazy. There's gatekeepers. You can't get in front of business owners. They're just too busy. But guess what? They have a mobile phone, and it's attached to them at all times. And guess what the number one app on Facebook, or actually the number one app on the iPhone or any other smartphone? It's Facebook. You know, Facebook has a huge, huge reach because of its mobile app. It hasn't quite figured out the ad network on the mobile device, but it does have a huge reach. So people can be reached all the time, but it's actually through Facebook now. And I've seen this transition as well as, you know, I'm sure everybody here can attest to the fact that more and more business is being taken place on Facebook every day. You can see different groups popping up, especially in our niche, in internet marketing, of course. But even outside of this, I've seen huge, huge groups, real estate agent associations, and we'll show you this in just a second. So, and this works, this Open Graph technology, it works pretty much everywhere in all the main countries right now, and they're rolling it out more and more. It was in beta for some time, so this is all pretty new still. And they're going to keep refining the technology and making it better for us to find out exactly who we want to target and who we want to build relationships with. And, you know, if you've been in the offline consulting niche for some time, you realize it's not so much about selling as it is about building relationships and making connections. And there's no better way to do this than on Facebook. As you can see, you know exactly who they are, you know where they live, you know what they like to read, you know what interests they have. You can click on them for more information to find out what they like. You know, there's just so much information here at the tip of your finger that you can never know by buying a lead list and making a phone call and trying to go through the normal processes of kind of like the 1900s versions of marketing now, really, the cold call and the direct mail piece. And, you know, all that stuff works, and I've made a lot of money using these strategies as well. But, you know, with the technology that we have at our fingertips now, there's no reason not to use it, especially for all of us here as internet-savvy individuals. So really a huge opportunity. You have to start using the Open Graph feature, and you already have it. You know, it's free. It's already part of Facebook. You just log into your account, and then you're really, really good to go. And they'll give you suggestions when you do this Facebook tool up top. So you can type in something like owners who live in London, or you can say, like, restaurant owners who live in my hometown. You know, you can do all types of different searches. You just have to play around with that, figure out what works for you, and figure out what your target market is, and go on and build relationships with individuals. Now, of course, this is all manual, and it does take some time. So if you want to learn the easier way of doing it, which the way I recommend, we'll show this in a few minutes. And then lastly, let's say if you want to get higher paying clients, let's say you can type in CEOs who work at Ford, or who work at Google, or presidents, or, you know, managers, sales managers. There's all different types of positions that people list on their profile for you to go ahead and find out who they are. So some of them will be little kids pretending they're presidents of, you know, America or whatever, if you type that in. But you'll find a lot of really serious, you know, high potential quality contacts you can make. And if you've heard the phrase, your network, your net worth is how big your network is, and that's really true here. And you can really build some high quality relationships with people. I've ran an ad targeting auto dealers to get auto dealer clients, and one guy that responded to my ad, I checked out his profile on Facebook, and he had nothing but pictures of him flying around in jets, yachts, Lamborghinis. It was just ridiculous. The guy is at least an 8-figure earner per year. He is loaded. So that's a great contact to build a relationship, even if it takes a little while, you know, to have him as a contact for more business. You can imagine that your average $500 or $1,000 deal for a website or whatever is going to be a little bit larger. So a lot of opportunity here with targeting down to people that probably have more money to spend on your services. So, you know, here's a few more examples. Let's say if I wanted to find out, you know, Dr. Dan, I have him on my friends list. I could say friends who live in Newport Beach, and then I can go ahead and I'd see him on the list, and I'd see whoever else lives there, right? But I can also say, let's say Dan wants to do a search and connect with other business owners in Newport Beach. Well, he can do this search as well on Facebook. He just has to type in business owners who live in Newport Beach, California. Facebook does all the work, and there you go. You have a lot of connections locally. You know, you could do this. You could go to networking events and or, you know, these daily, weekly meetups and do all that kind of work. But, you know, working from home is that advantage where you don't have to if you don't want to. And personally, I don't want to. I'd rather just sit on here, connect with people, and actually find out more information about them and see if they'd be a good fit before I even decided to contact them. But I'd rather have them contact me. And we'll share that in just a few moments here. So what happens is these people are business owners. They want to get together with other business owners. They too see the power of Facebook just like we do. Well, they form their own groups. So Atlanta Real Estate Agents, for example, has a group of 735 members. It's open, so you can go ahead and join. But what will happen is most of these people are real estate agents, but then there's a few that join to try to sell them different things, right? Well, how do they do this? Well, they spam messages in the group, right? Don't want to be that guy. You really don't. And Tampa Bay Real Estate Agents, same thing. So there's groups for all different types of industries, business owners, associations. There's so many possibilities. There's probably over a million different groups on Facebook now, and many of these have thousands of members. So this is a great opportunity to connect, build some value in here. And instead of just spamming up a message like, hey, buy my services, go to my website, like my page, you can offer real value and contact a lot of people. Perhaps you want to post a blog message, content message, or maybe a quick video and like, oh, trying to get more leads for your Tampa Bay real estate agency. Well, here's three strategies to help you get more leads in Tampa Bay. So something that's really targeted for them that can build value and show that you're an expert at what you do, credibility, and then you can go ahead and lead them to your website. So you can do that through a YouTube video, through a blog post, just something really quick, just sharing an article even that's not even yours. And here's an example of a much larger group. So let's just say you need to get contact more people. That's fine. There's plenty of groups out there. And this is just one example. You know, there's a million plus real estate agents, but here's just one group of close to 6,000 people. So in a few moments, we're going to show you how you take all these and contact them all at once. Southern California real estate agents right here, another real estate agent group, and there's countless others. And as I mentioned, you don't want to be that guy. So the average marketer or business owner will be like, oh, I'll just, you know, it's free just to put a message into the group. And, you know, I have a lot of groups that I'm a moderator in, and I'm a part of a lot of groups. Nobody likes that guy. Nobody's ever going to buy anything from him. Yeah. Don't so be that I know a lot of you are thinking, okay, so I can just, no, that's not a shortcut. You don't want to take that shortcut. I know it looks easy. Like, okay, I'll just join the group and I'll post up my blog or post up, you know, like, hey, click here or call me if you want leads for your business. And, yeah, that just doesn't work. You know, it's kind of like when you go out to a bar, you're trying to meet someone. You don't ask them out on the date when you're right there. First, you get a drink or you introduce yourself, right? Same thing applies. We a lot of times we forget that in social media. And I've seen this quite a lot. Okay, so what happens if you don't have a lot of time, right, and you want to get more leads? Oh, we just got a comment saying, I can't wait to spam people. So, yeah, now you know how to spam people. I've showed you how.
From Boughton.
So instead of doing that method, I recommend highly that you let Facebook do it all for you. And that way, you don't have to spend any time doing it. You don't have to get flamed off the group and banned. And you don't have to be that guy. You know. So what you can do actually with Facebook, for just a few dollars, really, it's not even that much, you can target entire groups of business owners. You can target roofers. Here's a few examples here on top. National Association of Women Business Owners. People that own restaurant owner, DBA, small business owner, small business, chiropractor, or local business owner, self-employed business owner. I think you get the point. So you can contact all different types of industries, or you can try to get them all at once. Or perhaps you just want to go after roofing contractors, right? Well, you can type into Facebook, okay, let me put together a campaign to target industrial roofers, roofer, sheet metal roofer, and more roofers. So what this will do is actually you'll be able to target an advertisement right to those people, and it's all automated. And it's very rarely that you'll spend more than a few dollars to get some really decent, high-quality leads that could be worth tens of thousands of dollars to your consultant's business. So, and of course, if you want to target Miley Cyrus people, you know, all fans, you know, assuming there's any exists that are still out there, you can do that as well.
I'm sure there are. People are still talking about that.
Yeah, I think she's getting more popular. I don't understand, but I like to target roofers and, you know, things like that. Chiropractors, you can really target it down to a specific niche. And that way, you can put together a marketing message right for them, right? Go after a certain niche and try to focus in on that niche. I like to do this quite a lot, so you can do it with auto dealerships, dentists, doctors, restaurant owners, salons. You know the list. I mean, there's so many local businesses out there. I'm sure you're pretty aware. So you may have one that you want to specialize in. Guess what? You can target them on Facebook as well. Really, the precise interests are literally endless. And then now, thanks to Ology and this tool that we have, now we can even take those lists that I showed you before, those groups, and extract all those people and target them in one campaign as well. And this is a huge advantage that nobody else has other than us, the people that use our product, right? So it's kind of under the radar still, you know, even as such a popular product locally, you know, within our group. But, you know, worldwide, you know, there's so many people still wondering, how does this Facebook thing work? So you're really here at the right time to get this information, so you'll be ahead of the curve. And what this does is this product, you can extract groups, you can extract events, pages, posts, people. You can find out more information about them. But what you can do with this is specifically, I showed you some examples of it earlier, these groups, so Atlanta real estate agents, Tampa Bay real estate agents, real estate agents networking group. You can take these groups who specifically said, yes, I'm a real estate agent and I want to network and I want to get more leads for my business. So I'll jump here on Facebook. There's so many advantages to this. First off, they know how to use Facebook, so that means they understand the power of the internet to some level, right? Secondly, they've said, okay, I'm going to join a group. And thirdly, now you can extract that ID and you can target them directly. And it's literally just a few pennies per click. And it's just so cheap right now. We're going to show you some examples of that in a little while.
You're basically cherry-picking your audience, which is a huge advantage than any other advertising method before this.
Well, and yeah, guys, and going even a step beyond that, the power of this, I mean, for those of you, our fellow rock star landlords out there, you know, who are in the business of generating leads for specific topics and niches, man, imagine the power this puts you in, you know, being able to tap into this and be the power broker of, hey, I know how to get these leads I know how to tap into your audience at will. I mean, that just makes you, you know, the king of the block. And not just for yourself, but for anybody else who wants to work with you and be able to hone in on your magic.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. This puts us. Yeah. You know, this is something I've been using for a year, pretty quietly up until recently, where people were like, "What are you doing? How did you do that? Like, how you can literally take one person, put them into a custom audience on Facebook, and make an advertisement to them." So let's just say you have a high-profile prospect. You know, if you land this deal, it could be worth tens of thousands of dollars to your offline business. You can actually, you know, find out their ID, extract that ID, put that into a group, and put a whole marketing message for them. But number one, they get the message loud and clear as much as you can send it to them, which is pretty much all day, every day they log into Facebook. And number two, it shows that, hey, this guy, you know, this gal, this person knows what they're doing. You know, they've created an ad that took the time to do this, and I see this right on my screen. So it's hugely powerful, and it's another strategy that you can use in doing this. So, for example, we want to take a group like the Real Estate Agents group right here. So we can put this into a custom audience, run an advertisement for literally $5 or $10, and we can market the message around them. Say, like, hey, you know, I saw that you were looking for investors. I saw you're a real estate agent, you know, I was looking for investors, and guess what, you know, I can help you get more leads, make more connections, whatever you want to do. You can specifically put together an advertisement right for that audience. And they're like, wow, that's pretty cool. How did they do that? And they're probably going to contact you because they don't even know what's going on. They don't really know that you have some kind of, you know, secret sauce software in the background, right, that's creating these custom groups. All I know is, like, somehow he's, like, targeting me. I don't know how he's doing it. So, yeah, like everybody's been saying here, you know, it's such an advantage compared to what we have had before, where with Facebook, you know, a couple of years ago, you know, there wasn't really anything you could do to really target business owners. There was no open graph. There was really no advertising platform where you can target businesses. So just recently, we've had this software and, you know, some new advances with Facebook. It's just ridiculous what you can do with targeting now, and it doesn't really cost a thing. Yeah. So, I mean, if you want to save time and save money.
Yeah. No, just to throw something in there, I mean, one of the main reasons I wanted this software developed and put out there in the market was because Facebook, you know, had gone IPO, so they're a publicly traded company now. So they need to make sure that they're making money. And then they opened up something called, which you were hitting on earlier, Ryan, was the Open Graph. That was their way of getting into the search market. And due to that reason, we have all these abilities of being able to pull data via the Facebook API. And this is completely compliant because I'm a Facebook app developer. So I make sure that my software is completely compliant with Facebook's terms of service. And everything that's done here is done through Facebook.
Yeah, I think that's really important to mention too, because we're getting some questions in here about how does this compare to this other software, this other thing that's so-and-so, and I'm not going to mention any names, but a lot of the other products out there that we've looked at, and that's why we haven't done webinars with any of those people, is because a lot of them are using loopholes within Facebook that will get shut down or could get you banned, so that's why we don't mess with them, and that's why when we looked at Ali G's stuff here, we're like, okay, this is legit. We're not going to get in any trouble here. It's above board. That's why we're actually doing this webinar.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Absolutely true. And I know, speaking for Ali G and myself as software developers, we have to look at those terms of services, and we realize that there's so many products out there that violate multiple terms of services of Facebook, of Yelp, of Google, or whatever. And they get away with it for some time, but at some point, they're going to get shut down, and guess what happens? The customer is left, without a product, no refunds, and all of a sudden, vanished. That product will be gone. You can't get in contact with them. I've seen this happen a few times over the past few years.
I've had it happen to me. I spent over $1,000 on a software a few years ago, and I was using it for my own stuff, and I turned around and got banned like in the first month or something like that. From Facebook, and I was like, holy shit, because I had like 3,000 to 4,000 friends and stuff on that account, and I didn't know, and so I had to basically beg them, I'm sorry, I blamed it on somebody else. I said, I hired an assistant, they told me that they were going to get me legit fans and or people and this and that, and so then they said, okay, don't let it happen again. I was like, oh my God, I almost lost my entire life.
Dr. Dan was devastated. Like, I lost 4,000 friends today.
Yeah. It sucked.
Oh, man.
And the possibilities of this is endless. Of Facebook, you're the largest audience on earth, adding new members in every day. It's not on the downside at all. It's continuing to get better. The ad platform is getting better. The Open Graph technology is getting better. The software, Social Lead Freak, is getting better with new updates. And guess what? More and more people are having success with it, and more people are getting to know about it. So you definitely want to jump in on this early before everybody has it, and then it's just kind of like the thing that people have. But now we're a long way from there, I believe. So huge, huge market out there that need something to get more leads. And really, this answer is Facebook. So you can do this with any type of market, any type of product or service. It doesn't have to be offline. You can target, get businesses, as clients, and then use a Facebook strategy for them as well, like targeting their potential customers and reach in their own realm. So, 25 miles from the location, right? You can target different demographics, age groups, what they like. And all of a sudden, you have ridiculously targeted campaign. And you can get down as low as, say, 5, 10 cents per click going to a website. It's just ridiculously cheap, especially at the local level. And if you have a targeted campaign, it's going to kill it. So, don't worry. I know if you may be thinking, oh, I have to put this, I have to extract this, put this into a campaign, and then, run ads. Like, no, you already have the ad platform. You've never run ads before. You can literally set up a dollar a day, $5 a day, and most of the time, it doesn't even hit the max. So these campaigns will be pretty small, but that's where the power comes in. Even if you have just, say, 1,000 or 2,000 business owners, potential reach, you can do a whole lot with that little reach. And we'll show you just a second here. So who's ready to see the exact process of how to put together offline campaigns successfully using Facebook? If you are, press yes. Put yes into the chat box. It's going to be a three-step process that I've put together for you. It's really, really simple. So if you've gone away, you don't have the screen up, pull it back up. You're going to want to see this. I'm going to run through this pretty quickly, and I'm not going back.
We're getting some comments about the picture here. Just so you guys know, that's Ali G's twin sister, and she is single, and that's why he put her there, because he's trying to hook her up, trying to find a nice guy.
Oh, yeah, I forgot to put the phone number in there, Ali. I don't know if you wanted to share that.
Oh, yeah, I'm glad you left that out.
Well, you can just call Ali G direct, right?
Yeah.
Ali,
like
what's
that.
Your number? Hold on.
Ali G will be in Manhattan on Saturday, so yeah, maybe we can get the hookup there. So
it's 646-479.
Come on,
8244.
All right, no screwing around. I want to get to the money. Get to the money.
Yeah, I think everybody else does too. I see 50 yeses. Shake your tree.
That's awesome. I love your peaches.
Get to the money. Yeah, I like that comment.
All right. Let's see.
All right, so.
A little distraction.
Step one, with that awesome software you just saw, you're going to be able to download that in a second. But once you get that software, you want to do some searches, find out some groups, say local groups, some different business associations. Try all different types of things. You can use the Open Graph to do a search to find out some. And they'll even give you suggestions like, oh, do you want a similar groups here? You're in the New Jersey Business Associations group with 1,000 people in it. Why don't you like this group too? This is the Newark Group Association with 7,000 people in it. And so you'll find that finding groups and finding business owners online is really easy. So we're going to give you the really simple process here, but afterwards you're going to have the complete training on how to do all of this. So don't worry. We're going to do a recap at the end, and as a bonus, we'll give you an extra special bonus, so you got to stick around for that. So what you have to do is step one, you set up your custom campaigns. Yeah, I've been killing it with this. This is my actual own custom audiences that I've set up. Some of them are pretty large. You can see almost 25,000. So in total, I have somewhere around 50,000 targeted prospects. So these are for multiple businesses. So some of these are smaller groups of business owners, and then some are more IM niches and things like that. So you can upload as many custom audiences as you need. You can name them like, okay, this is my doctor's group. You know, this is my lawyer's group. You can put custom campaigns literally for them and set up a budget of a few dollars. You know, you probably won't even spend it for the entire month. Here's an example of an ad that you can run. So it's really this simple. You have to have a fan page, assuming you have, you know, probably you already do. If not, it takes 2 seconds to create one, post up a couple things on there, and you get going. And then a simple ad like this is, I'm just saying, you know, attention to the business owners. Make sure, you know, because most of them will be business owners, but you'll get, you know, a few odds and ends kind of in those groups as well, in those interest groups. But 90% of them will be legitimate business owners that you want to target. So it's going to be really well concentrated. So you want to make sure that you get the message out there. Just keep it really simple. And you can offer like a free consultation, a free report, or a free webinar. If you don't want to do a webinar, that's fine. I like to keep it really easy. They just go right to my website, and then I have a contact form. They can fill it out, or they can contact me direct through my phone number. So that way, I get as many leads as I can, but I don't have to go out and get, you know, go after them. They're coming to me. And what's better is I can run this ad, I can set it up once, and then it's done. I don't even look at it again, because I know it's a targeted group of prospects, you know, using the processes that we showed you. You know, it's so simple. It's just like, well, okay, how can I target a lot of little business owners? I put them into a group, I put up a little quick ad, and then boom, it's just set to go. And then finally, once you have your promoted post up, well, then you have to set up the targeting for your advertisement. And this is where the custom audiences and the precise interests come in. So there'll be two separate ads. The first one you'd want to do would be precise interests. And like I showed you earlier on, roofers, chiropractors, you know, you probably want to keep these separately, but I just showed you a few examples here that you can search for and put them into an advertisement. So I'm targeting 12,000 who live in New Jersey between the ages of 40 to 60, which is basically all of my clients are within those ages, so I know that's my target audience, and who are in parts of different associations or different groups. And then finally, you just set up your optimization. So I like to optimize, do a cost per click. because you can run these ads all day and you end up only paying between 20 to 40 cents per click. That's your max click right there, 50 cents. But that's usually around the average, around the norms, what we've found and tested out. So, I mean, it's really, really cheap. Where else can you get business owners to go find out about your services for 20 cents? I mean, on AdWords, you'd be paying $10, $20 per click, you know, going after website design or, you know, online marketing services or, you know, all those different types of keywords. You'll be paying a ridiculous amount of money, even upwards of $50 per click. We're talking about paying 20, 30 cents maybe. You know, it's not even a comparison. So these types of ads, you don't even have to think about it. You just run it. You run as many people as you can to it as long as they're targeted, and you get as many leads as you can because it's just like unlimited leads available, and Facebook's the largest audience available to us on the internet. And that's it. That's literally how simple it is. You set up your custom audience. You figure out who you're going to target. You know, put those interest groups into a campaign, right? You can put them down on a piece of paper, you know, just, you know, save something saved on a notepad. And then you create your post, something simple like we've done, set up your ad, and then go on with your life. that's the simple process of it. So I've literally set up ads like you've just seen. I hit the, okay, create my campaign. I set up the ad and then walked away from it and just keep it running. You know, I keep getting impressions. And if I get a click or two or three, you know, you can get a few hundred depending how large your the reach is, how many people you have in that group. But the thing is, I don't really care. I want to get as out to many business owners as possible because I realize that, number one, they're on Facebook. They understand that it's important. And number two, 20 cents per click or something. So for an entire month, an average campaign, I may spend $10 on something like that for a month. And, you know, in the past, I've done things such as, you know, during direct mail campaigns, I would easily drop $1,000 to $2,000 on a simple direct mail campaign, and then I'd have to wait about a month to start seeing any calls, if any, coming back to me. And, you know, then I'd go through the whole process of like, well, you know, we kind of had it laying around here and we didn't take action on it, and then, oh, then I have to talk to, you know, it's a whole process, but you have to wait through the mail. But this is instant, so I'm all about instant results. I know exactly how many people clicked on my ad. I know exactly how many impressions I've got. And then if you have Google Analytics on your site, you can track all that kind of stuff as well, conversions, or if you want to send them to a lead page or whatever and capture their email and phone number. But, you know, just to keep it easy, just send them right to your homepage or for a website. If you don't have a website, have a contact form, some kind of form where you can grab their information so you can call them back when you're ready to. So I like to run my business on my own terms as much as possible, and this is how you do it. Like I said, once you have these three steps set up, you just go on with your life. And we put together a ridiculous package. To be honest, we've never done this before. This is the first time, to be honest. Ali G and myself, you know, we've had these killer Facebook products out for some time now, but we've never put them together where you get both into one. So if you click on that link below, we're going to tell you a little bit about this, but here it is in a nutshell. What you need to do to guarantee your success going forward here. Yeah, I've gone through the three steps. You know, they're pretty simple, but there's a lot of nuances to it if you're brand new to using Facebook and advertising. And so we have the best Facebook lead extraction tool on the planet right now with Ali G's Social Lead Freak. It's been product of the day on JVZoo twice, which I'm almost 100% sure I don't think any product's ever gotten that twice. I think that's pretty much the only time ever. and not only that, but it's completely compliant with Facebook, which is hugely important because as far as we've tested and seen other tools, there isn't anything else out there that's compliant, as you know, Dr. Dan and Ali G has mentioned. So this is huge, guys. If you want a tool that's going to be around for a long time and that's going to give you updates and support, you're going to want to have this one. You know, as we mentioned, there's other ones out there, which I know I wouldn't even touch, considering I already know who programmed it. You know who has the support, and I know I can go to him, get some new updates to it, and really kill it. So there's going to be some new updates coming out in the future too with Facebook APIs and Open Graphs and all that kind of stuff. You're going to be the first to know with the package that we put together here for you. Now, I have a Facebook product, and this is what I'm talking about as far as putting together a two-for-one package we've never done before. So Ali G invited me here today to give you guys a special bonus for anyone taking action on our package here today. So I have a Facebook training course membership site. It's called Facebook Social Lead System. It's created by myself with the help of my coaching students and many of her local marketers themselves, including me. So this is with your business in heart, and we have over 1,500 members in there. So it's a large group. We have a great communication support system, and we have a Facebook group, which actually everybody here on the call is already in there. We're all very active in there. So we offer a pretty ridiculous package. You know, Mario Brown, Mark Helton, and William Mears have all just posted up some really awesome statistics that they're doing with Facebook. So no matter if you're doing local, whatever product or service you're doing, you're going to need this social lead freak and, you know, a system, support system to help you as new updates are continually going out with Facebook, as just recently what we showed you here in this webinar. That Open Graph technology is still pretty new and still being updated right now. So, you know, that's a big thing of mine. That's a big tenet for, my business as well as Ali's, is that you need support, you need updates, you need to have success, you need like a system in place where you can plug into. And, you know, we realize that, you know, that three-step process is pretty simple, straight to the point. You may be able to go ahead and do it on your own if you're pretty savvy, but if you need the support structure, well, obviously you need the tool. So we have a link down below. I believe someone can put it into the chat box, make sure that everybody has this. It's tworockstarslike.com/SLF. And what you're getting is you're getting the Facebook tool, just to recap. You're getting the Facebook training, which I offer this right now on my website for $100. You're getting in that for completely free as a special bonus to me. And then my group coaching program is also being thrown in there for free, along with all of us already in the group. So here's a few examples of some of my clients and then some of the people here in our Facebook group having success with this. You know, I've been able to generate over $100,000 now using Facebook just this year in sales, and I've spent somewhere around $5,000 on my ads the entire year. So the ROIs on that is pretty large, say $5,000 to $100,000. And these are just rough estimates because I've run multiple campaigns and I have about 7 campaigns going on right now. That's somewhere around 2,000% ROI. And a lot of this is because of the tenets, really the training that you saw here today, getting the most targeted list possible and targeting the biggest amounts as possible. So it's a 2-for-1 here. And here's one of my coaching students who just about a month ago, he ran something similar to what I've showed you before, but he ran it to a webinar. So he ran roofers, he ran a roofer campaign. And out of that, one guy who didn't even show up live for the webinar, he left after a couple of minutes. He just called a week later, and that turned into a 6-month contract for $12,000. And if he comes on full time after that, it'll be turning into more of a $20,000 to $30,000 contract. So cost him $170 to get $12,000 in sales for his business for offline. So that's pretty significant, and that's for someone that's never done advertising in his life outside of AdWords, where he spent out, I think, somewhere around $500 without getting a single lead. So with Facebook, he now got, I think, around 20 to 25 leads, if I remember correctly, for that $170. With one turning into a $12,000 contract. So it's really such a huge advantage over what everybody else is doing right now.
Hey, Ryan, could you real quickly, because we have a bunch of questions coming in, I'm sure you'll probably cover it if you're about to just say, I'm about to cover that, but could you? We have a lot of questions coming in about what the differences are on the licenses.
Yeah, Ali G, I think that's a perfect question for you.
Yeah, because people are already clicking on here, and they're absolutely like, well, which one do I buy?
Yeah, well, there's the license differences are basically the pro license, which is the most popular. That gives you free range to install Social Lead Freak on as many machines throughout your business and your business team, or say if you have outsourcers, you can share your login information, and then they can use Social Lead Freak and all the power that it gives you, and that can be extended to them as well. The standard license, which is for 147, that is for three machines max. So it could be, you know, your laptops, your desktops, or three machines. And of course, there's the light license, which is for just one machine, you know, whatever computer you have, so you can use it. And none of the versions have any limitations on what they can do or can't do. The only limitations are as far as how many machines they can be installed on.
That's as easy as it gets right there.
Yeah, and there's going to be quite a few people, like me and Ben were talking about this, where they're just going to be like, oh, well, you know, I only need it on one computer, but, you know, I can just deal with the one computer, but I'd like to have it on more than one, so I'll just go for the cheaper option. Here's our take on it. Ali G is going to raise the price on this. This price is not going to stay here at what it is right now. So let's say you do need to install it in the future on two or three computers because you get a partner or because you want it on two machines or three machines. Or an outsourcer.
You want an outsourcer to use it, yeah.
Yeah, so now you're not going to be able to just contact them and be like, well, LEG, I bought from a webinar a while back at a lower price. Can you hook it up? He's going to be like, no, sorry, it's $9.97 for another license.
Yeah, so the prices are going up. Yeah, the prices are going up as I'm about to introduce more features. Just this weekend, I'm about to introduce some new features to Social Lead Freak. And then in a couple weeks, because I get the developer updates, there's going to be a major Facebook API update, which is going to allow even more more features to Social Lead Freak. And of course, existing customers will get the update automatically. You don't have to do anything; it just automatically updates. But anyone that misses out on these prices will of course be paying the higher price in the very near future.
Yeah, and our friend Lawton put a funny message in there, but it's true. I mean, he's like, so it sounds like we have three choices: one, give up on our current marketing, go back to a regular job; two, try to figure it out on our own and figure out the groups and the custom audience and all this stuff; or three, give this amazing system that pretty much puts it on autopilot for you a real fair try. Love that, Lawton. Thanks for sharing that.
Yeah, we already have somebody here that already has I don't want to buy a remorse, but they're already asking, can I upgrade now because I accidentally bought the light license and I don't want to get stuck with the with just one license and then have to buy another license in the future at a higher price point. That's why I wanted to mention that early on, because I knew there's going to be a lot of people that would be like, oh, well, I'll just go with the lowest one because I can just use it on one computer. But it is going to happen in the future where you are going to want to install it more than one computer, and then you're going to be stuck. And we don't want that to happen to you. We're always trying to tell you guys, you know, the up and up. So I cannot endorse buying the one site license. If you buy it, that's your fault. I would get the three site.
It's better than getting nothing at all. But you know, this thing is awesome, and this is what we're using to make it so much easier to do what we do. But with that said, with those questions answered, I'd like to, Brian, to keep going, because I know we're going to show you some more like real examples and give you an actual like demo over our shoulder if we can get it. You know, if we don't have any glitches there.
Yeah, I pulled up Social Lead Freak here on my screen so you can see this. So people are asking, now, what does the software do, especially how it might be different or better than other softwares? Well, first off, this is the only software that I'm aware of that doesn't violate Facebook TOS. So basically, there is no anything other products that we could show you that might be better or different, because you know those are likely kept private because they will be banned, as we've seen a couple of products, especially Facebook products, be completely banned, wiped off the face of the earth, and the users and everybody involved got shut down, right? So as far as different softwares, I'm not sure if there is any. I haven't seen any, and you know, I'm always looking to see if there's something else out there, maybe a new product or feature that we could bring into this one here. But what it does is, once you get the login screen here, you'll log into Facebook, so it connects with your Facebook account, and this is the way you can go ahead and start searching for, say, groups and start polling these, which the next step would just be actually adding them to Facebook. So you do a simple search, something like this. You want to go out for real estate agents. Let's try real estate investing. You know, whatever types of different groups. There'll be whole lists here. So some will be closed, some will be opened. You can right-click on each group. You can find out more information about them on Facebook itself. So you can find out, you know, what's going on in that group. Is this some kind of data that I want to pull? It's a closed group. You can join it, and then you can go ahead and extract IDs later. This is a closed group, and I can extract IDs right off the bat, so that's really, really cool. And this works for a lot of different things. So there's different tabs here. You'll see events, places, pages, posts. Same things will apply. You can search for an event, say upcoming event for real estate agents. The same thing would apply here. You can pull places information for data research. Let's say if you want to pull out, you know, some business data. So similar to like a Google search, like a Google Plus listing. Places is the place to go, but it's Facebook. And pages, you can do a search for pages as well. So same thing. Real estate agents, you want to find some pages. You can find out more information about it in a simple search. So it's easy to see the data here with Facebook. They only allow you to see a certain amount. So right here is an entire long list that you wouldn't be able to get access to with Facebook. And it's neatly shown here. So you can go ahead and extract as well from this. And then you can also go to the page to find out more information about it on Facebook itself.
Yeah, there's a couple questions here I just wanted to answer over here. Somebody's asking, can you search closed groups? Yes, you can search closed groups, and you can even extract member IDs from closed groups. There is a tutorial video in the members area, so whoever gets involved will be able to see that in its entirety. So you can exactly start doing that. Another question, can this extract email addresses? Extracting email addresses, it has the ability. As you know, Ryan's just been showing here, there's a converter tab, and the converter tab allows you to, with one click, convert all the member IDs into email addresses. So you do have that ability, and you can market to people via email if you so choose.
Very cool.
Cool. So questions keep coming in. If you guys can like run off the most relevant questions, we can get going one by one. I'll keep going demoing what you're getting here in this package. So,
sorry to interrupt you. You could keep doing your thing. Yeah, no, sorry to interrupt you. I just wanted to answer this couple questions that were coming in again and again.
Okay, so we're going to go ahead and also demo what you'll be getting in as a free bonus. And like I said earlier, this is something we've never done before. Ali G and myself actually sell these products separately. So you're getting this completely for free. This is actually sold for $100, and the Facebook group itself is an extra $97. So what you're getting here is completely free. You'll have access to, as a bonus, if you buy through Dr. Dan and Ben's link, you'll have access to this as the bonus. So Facebook Social Lead System is a complete membership site. It has a five-step process from, you know, A to Z as far as creating your ads, technology as far as using Open Graph, getting leads, getting individuals, pulling individuals, targeting individuals like I mentioned earlier on the call, but also set up retargeting for your ads, targeting small businesses, so we have extra training in here, importing your emails, saving email lists that you want to import and put an advertisement out to. You can even buy email lists. So all these types of things we'll go over. And advanced training. So once you get past that next level, once you have your first ads running, you're going to need some advanced training. We have that in here as well. So using things such as the Open Graph technology, Power Editor, and a whole bunch of videos on there, how to create webinars, setting up squeeze pages, setting up landing pages for your offers, using Facebook promoted posts in more detail. So we have somewhere around 4 to 5 hours of training in here, all broken down, and then we have access also to the Facebook Mastery Group, which all of us are in, and is very active, and we're posting up real results. So these aren't, it's not like we're doing something, we're selling you something and not doing it, right? This is something that I've been doing personally for over 12 months. I've gotten over 1 million impressions using Facebook, and you know, this Social Lead Freak and then Facebook's, you know, advertising tool has made me a ridiculous amount of money. And also my clients are just really going all out with Facebook advertising. So it's been a huge shift over the past year. We've seen so many people jumping into this. But the thing is, you still have to know how to do it right. And so you'll have all the training and support needed going forward here, all with the special bonus here that we're offering.
Let's see, somebody's asking, since Facebook is mostly social, what kind of ROI will a marketer tend to get on average? that question, I mean, from all the campaigns that, you know, Ryan and I've been running, Ryan, like, you've been showing, I mean, you've been showing some amazing ROIs, like, as high as 8,000%, right?
Yeah, absolutely. My ROI for the entire year, all of my combined advertisements, has been somewhere around 2,000% altogether for the entire year. So I spent somewhere around $5,000 on ads on Facebook, and I've brought in somewhere close to $100,000. So that's just personally. So, say you're brand new to it. Well, you know, someone like Connor Gilson, one of my coaching students, this is something that we were testing out a while ago. I'm like, hey, why don't you just try running some, you know, traffic to a webinar and go after some business owners. So we're trying to figure out this technique, but we haven't really shared it with a whole lot of people. So right now, there's not a whole lot of people doing it, but the people that we have doing it are having a lot of success. You know, he spent $170 to make $12,000. You know, if he nurtures that relationship, I mean, that can be close to $100,000 lifetime value deal. So what I mean by lifetime value, when you're calculating ROI, it's not all about what you sell them initially, right? My average client, my offline business, is worth about $10,000. There's some that have paid me close to $50,000, some upwards of $100,000 lifetime, and have referred me extra business, and that I actually calculate in. So really, if you're paying 20 to 30 cents per click to get a business owner to find out about what you're offering, I pay that all day. You're going to have ROIs of just ridiculous proportions. It's not going to be like the thing where you spend a dollar to make two, right? You're not selling an ebook or like a $10 product. You're selling a vital service to a small group, a targeted group of business owners that are on Facebook already and looking for ways to get more leads, let's face it, because we all are. Guess what? We have the solution right here. So ROIs will definitely vary a lot depending on what your price points are for your product or service. So if you have higher end consulting services where, like, say $10,000 is like your buy-in, I've seen people do that, you know, you're going to get a high ROI.
Let me tell you guys right now exactly how we are using this this system. Thank goodness we got a chance to start using this tool, because we were doing it like an old convoluted way where we were having to do a lot of guesswork and a lot of extra steps that we don't have to do anymore thanks to this. But here, I mean, in our business, one of the greatest ways we are generating leads for some of our high-end business consulting programs is that we are actually going in and targeting very specific groups, very specific niches, and we're not even worried so much about geotargeting. We've done both, and they both work great, but we're getting these really inexpensive clicks by being able to target the right people, and we're sending them to a webinar, to an evergreen webinar. That's, you know, that's one of the ways we're doing. There's so many different ways. We have pages. If we're gonna build up a whole niche and topic and everything else, where we can build up a whole fan base and be able to lease those assets, you know, like we talk about in our landlord methods. But if we're trying just to go straight up for a consulting client where somebody's paying us, you know, $10,000 or $20,000 or something, we're leading them right to a webinar. So we're getting leads. We're getting an opt-in automatically if you're using, you know, one of those, you know, automatic webinar programs, and you're getting them opt-in whether they take action or not, and then you're sending them to take an action from the webinar, and it's usually like apply to get this consultation or to get this 30-minute you know consult or whatever it is, and we're just sending them right there. There's so many different ways you can take this traffic and tame it and bring it into your funnel, but you know, the first step, the most crucial step, is being able to pinpoint and target with precise focus who that audience is, and to be able to do it fast and easy like this, man, it just makes it so, man, you know, what used to take me an hour to do, I can go and load my funnel up and start bringing in business for Dan and I on anything we're doing, whether it's a landlord asset or straight up trying to get a consulting gig. Whatever we're doing, we can load that up in a couple minutes. I mean, that effort is very painless. And thanks, Ollie, and thanks, Ryan. I mean, this thing kicks ass. And if you haven't got it yet, you're crazy.
Yeah, absolutely. And just to add on to that, what you were saying is it doesn't really matter what you're sending them to. Is, yeah, I've done them all, and they all work. So, yeah, I've sent people right to my website where they can see kind of like a portfolio of some of my clients, and they can also fill out, you know, the kind of call to action, you know, is your website visible to others? And, you know, these aren't, you know, 100% professional or whatever, but they work because I have the targeted list. So that's really the most important part of what we're trying to say here is you need to have that targeted list of buyers, you know, people that are actually looking for your services. And guess what? You know, there's a small amount of local business owners. Perhaps you want to get local clients or national clients. There's only so many that are going to be looking for your services. But with Facebook, now we can target all of them at once. So it's pretty incredible. So this is one solution. You could do it like a consultation, kind of an opt-in form. You know, I've done this where I have a bunch of people that have opted in through my, you know, squeeze page. You know, all of us here at Internet Marketing have seen something like this. So they get a free report on how to get listed on Google. And here's a special video that I created that was targeting auto dealerships, and I have something similar. You know, just they opt in here, they can send me a message. And then I've done webinars, evergreen webinars, and live webinars too. So all different types of different things that all worked for me, and I've gotten business from all of them. Basically, it's just a matter of putting together what you feel most comfortable with. Is it a squeeze page? Is it just a consultation? Some kind of offer, something free, just to get them through the door, get their information so you can follow up when you're ready to do so. So that's the really cool thing about it. You don't have to be like, you know, waiting there or doing a webinar if you don't want to. Just do it the way you feel most comfortable.
Question here, because we have a couple people here. I think I saw somebody there and said they were in garage door repair, and then we have someone here who's a real estate photographer. So these are people who are true offline businesses themselves. They're not marketing to offline businesses. Okay, so Ryan, could you give us a quick rundown of how they can use this? You know, to do kind of the same thing, but to get leads for their own, you know, photography business, or, you know, real estate photography business, or the garage door repair business, and so on.
Cool, absolutely. Well, you know, I work with some local businesses where we run some Facebook ads, and these are things where I spend maybe $30 to $50 per month with them on this advertisement to get them, you know, somewhere between 100 to 200 clicks. And so that's going to be a huge amount of business, depending on what they want to do. If they want to scale it up, they can do that over across many networks. You know, AdWords and Facebook ads are working ridiculously well for local business owners. AdWords made some recent changes as well, where you can do ad extensions and have your phone number listed on mobile. But with Facebook, which is really cool, is you can literally target instantly, you know, certain radiuses. So let me pull up an example of a real campaign that I am currently running here.
And while he pulls that up, guys, pay close attention to this, because what he's about to show, how a local business owner themselves can do this, to put yourself in the hat of doing this for another local business owner, or for one of your own assets that you might lease to a local business owner, because this is where the money is, guys.
And so you know that if you buy through our link here today, you'll get access to all of this training within our product or in Facebook social lead system with offline businesses. There's a whole section for that. But let me go ahead and update my screen here and show you a real live campaign, nothing held back, so you can see exactly what I'm doing here. You can see I'm averaging somewhere between 5 to 15 clicks a day, targeting 58,000 people who live within 10 miles of. Now, this is a repair shop, so this is an auto repair shop. They have me on retainer, and this is just a simple ad. It literally took me about 2 minutes to set up this campaign. And I'm just, you know, who live in the United States, who live 10 miles within the town, and who are at least old enough to have a credit card, you know. So there's not a whole lot of targeting I have here that I need to get set up, but I'm running a promoted post. It's very basic. You know, save $3 on your next oil change. So you can also call the phone number directly, or you can click on the link. And this is mobile friendly as well. So I'm using a page here that I've set up for the business, and there's a mobile version as well. This is a desktop version. This goes to a Google offer. Facebook has their own offers as well. But I like using Google Offers. So they actually come in with this Google offer to the local business on their phone and like, hey, can I claim this offer? And so I've set this up with the local business owner where I can actually see how many are claimed every month. And so but just by this little thing alone, we're not spending a whole lot. You know, like I said, $30-$50 a month. So depending on how large your town is, how many people you want to target the ad, is really just scale it up. You're going to have success with an ad like this. It's just so simple. The power, it's very powerful as well, especially on a local scale.
Dan, you see any questions rolling in there? I see a few, but I want you to talk for a minute.
Well, thank you.
What Ryan just hit on right there is huge for offline marketers, because now you have a way of tracking. You have a way of tracking, you know, the business that's coming in due to the ads with Google offers. with Ryan, what he just pointed out, which is really huge in a way to track it, you know?
Yeah, well, Google has all these tools for free. I mean, I have an account with Analytics, so I know how many clicks I'm getting from my Facebook ads from Facebook itself, right? I can see how many, okay, I'm getting. I got 40 clicks over the last 7 days, 38 actions. I got 6 people to like the page, actually the post, and 32 page views. So that tells me, okay, they're taking a look. I've got 128 likes here. 5 people are sharing it. You know, that's cool. So because they're all local people within 10 miles of the location. So free shares, I'll take that. So I'm trying to use the virality of Facebook, which will give you an extra boost, plus the fact that it's all local. It's so easy to set this ad up. So literally took me a minute. And you know, use free tools that are out there, such as Google Offers, Analytics, and Facebook Analytics that's built into it, and then you're set to go. So you can have a report at the end of the month. You can actually print out reports or send them over to the business owner if they need them, and all that kind of stuff can be automated as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's a question here that I wanted to hit on. Adrian asked, are there a few ways to turn this into a service to offer to businesses? Yes, there absolutely. I mean, I have one of my customers that's he was an offline marketer who's basically now he's gotten his campaigns to a point where he knows what he can do and showing ROI. So he's been actually literally walking the streets of New York and hitting businesses, and businesses all know about Facebook. They all use it. They all use it when they're not supposed to be using it, when it really supposed to be working. And now they realize that, hey, you know, we can advertise on Facebook. They didn't even know that that was really a possibility. So he walks into businesses and opens up businesses to Facebook advertisements. What does he do? He basically takes a retainer, like for the monthly ad campaign. He usually charges like $1,000, $2,000. He might spend 500 of it, or maybe 1,000 of it, on ads. Like, you know, about half of it on ads. Keep the rest for his own operating expenses, and then he keeps 50% of the net profit generated from that campaign. So I mean, it's been really working out tremendously for him. You know, because now a business is getting business where they weren't expecting it from Facebook.
Yeah, and then it combined all along with AdWords, which is really good for local businesses. You're going to have a lot of success. So really, you know, SEO takes time. I've been training my offline consultants to really focus in on hitting some kind of ad campaign first, where you can take on a new client, so they don't get, you know, kind of felt like, oh yeah, you're doing some optimization for my page or for SEO or for social media or whatever, but I'm not seeing any results. So many times people, you know, they want results right away. They want more, you know, customers coming in as soon as you get hired. Like literally within 24 hours, they expect all this like massive surge. Because most local businesses don't understand what's going on, like how it works, you know. Literally, I had one of my clients say, okay, well, we have this product, so can you do $1 million in sales for the next 12 months? I'm like, no, I can't. With no ad budget, no nothing. Like, how is this going to happen? It's not magic, right? As we understand that now, you know, you can't just put up a website and they come in like a local business, you know. So this is different steps. So this is where the power for local business owners is going to come in. You can display these types of ads, set up something really simple, very short budget, just like Ali said, you know, take a half retainer for yourself, and then if you want to set up something like a commission or profit sharing model.
Exactly, yeah, it's been working out really great. I mean, my customer who's actually now, you know, doing this, he's been opening up a lot of law firms here in New York to Facebook marketing. Because, you know, people sometimes are on Facebook, you know, talking about how they might need a lawyer, or talking to their friends like, hey, do you know a lawyer? Now he's actually targeting, he's creating custom audiences and creating campaigns for law firms. And that's really big money for him so far.
What do you think those leads are worth to that lawyer? I mean, let's say that lawyer wasn't savvy enough to hire somebody just, you know, probably getting away with highway robbery, paying way lower than what he'd pay for the leads. I mean, but let's imagine that lawyer could get those, if you could just be the broker of those leads right to that lawyer. I mean, there's so many ways to do this and capitalize on it. I mean, I know if you're talking about like a, you know, look at like DUI attorneys, for example. I already know that just in the Dallas area, based on some things that Dan and I are doing with our landlording stuff, that, you know, they will pay anywhere between $50 and $250 for a lead for somebody who's actively looking to hire them, right? I mean, if we're taking this and doing it for them, they're going to pay us thousands of dollars a month to do that for them, or they're going to end up paying us thousands of dollars a month to lease that that property from us. So that's what I'm saying is, and if they are savvy enough, if you out there happen to be one of those DUI attorneys on this call right here, you could do this for yourself and not have to pay any of us. So, I mean, that's the power of this, because it's reaching an audience and being able to see who's got their hands up on what without having to dig through all kinds of crap and garbage to get there, which is the way we were doing it for a while. It still works. It's great. But, why make that complicated when this does it for you? And man, I wish this kind of training were available before Dan and I went to school Hard Knocks this last year.
Rockstar Ben, you hit a huge point right there, because going back to my buddy who's been hitting law firms, he's been hitting a lot of DUI law firms, and believe it or not, how he's been creating the custom audiences is that he's been going to local places that are known for copious amounts of drinking and big parties and so forth, and he's been grabbing those audiences from their fan pages and grabbing them from the groups that are associated with those. With those bars, lounges, clubs, and he's been grabbing perfect. Those people. Yeah, and it's kind of like
the audience that's most likely.
Right. It's like Minority Reports type of shit right there. It's like you're almost predicting maybe a crime from it happening, and a lot of people get themselves in those situations that are like, oh, what do I do? I got in trouble, I got a DUI, and he's been sending these custom audiences, the law firm advertisements, and he's been showing some tremendous returns. I was actually really surprised at how he was doing it.
We've said this time and time again, and to some of you this may feel like we're beating a dead horse, but when it comes to being a marketer, you have to truly be a marketer, because what a real marketer does, they understand the audience they're targeting. And that is what Ollie just shared is a perfect example. Because so many people focus only on very specific tactical action, meaning, okay, this is the group that buys this. Okay, maybe because they've said they buy that, right? But it's going one step deeper to actually, in your mind, developing an avatar. Okay, what's this person's favorite movie that's into this? What's this person's favorite, favorite music? What's this person, what restaurant does this person go to? And once you understand that and really get it down and understand what's their age, what's their gender, and you really have those things down, man, you could just unleash all kinds of hell and tap into audiences that, just like Ollie just said, that are ready to buy services or be perfect leads for your clients, for your landlord assets, everything. That's where the money is, guys. It's really tapping into that.
Yep, exactly.
We just got a comment in saying, I loved how you reached 6,400 people for $13. So, try to do that on AdWords.
It's auto repair. It's auto repair. It's highly... highly targeted, auto repair. This is a completely very niche-y.
How much would you spend on an AdWord campaign on that? Jesus.
usually, you end up spending even a very small town with no competition. The average click on AdWords is at least a minimum of $1 to $2 if you know what you're doing. If you don't, you can spend $10 to $20 per click. If the business owner signed up for an account, they did AdWords Express, or they tried to do it themselves. It's just AdWords will totally just route your money from you within a few days. It's totally unlike Facebook. Facebook, if you put up a campaign, say you just put a random max bid at $1,000, they'll only charge you 12 cents. But you try to do that on Google, they will charge you $1,000 per click if you put that max bid up that high. So you got to be careful with AdWords. If you don't know what you're doing, you can get screwed. Facebook is a lot more newbie friendly, I would say.
Then people will say, okay, well, what about SEO? And SEO is great. We still do it. We still do our Google Love stuff. But, some of the really, really targeted keywords, if you're doing auto repair Dallas, with the right effort, we can get that at some point. But, how much time you got versus, hey, let's spend $10 and just reach that audience right there on Facebook, quickly.
Yeah. It's just another way to do it. It's another way to skin the cat. And, it's a lot simpler if you don't want to understand SEO and offer that service. Then that's something you don't want to do. That's fine. But I always recommend trying to do a combination of all of them, and offering, you know, as a consultation, you know, that you can start off with the AdWords and then Google and Facebook marketing, right? Get those leads coming in right away, initially, as soon as you close the deal. And then once after some time, 3 to 6, 9 months go by, those SEO results will start coming in. So they have to understand that. You know, at first we'll do a big push, we'll get you some traffic right away to see. So make sure you have results, but long term, you got to have that organic traffic coming in well as well. So it's definitely congruent with the strategies that all the top marketing online marketing companies are doing. So it's a combination strategy. So not everybody can be reached on any platform, even Facebook with its ridiculous reach. Not everybody's on Facebook even. There's even a few places scattered throughout the world that who doesn't even know what Facebook or Twitter is yet, which is crazy. But
well, that's, where you can hire, one of those like sign spinner guys on the street. Right? Make up for that.
Yeah. Yeah, there's more ways to market now than ever before. So it's just a matter of understanding what medias you have out there and how to use them effectively.
Yeah, and so we have some more good questions coming up, but before we get to those, we'll take a few more minutes to answer all your awesome questions you have and address your comments. I did want to do a quick recap because I know some people people come and go, but recapping this, what you're getting here is you're getting this amazing tool that pretty much puts on autopilot being able to extract gold right out of Facebook. That's what's here. But even going a step beyond that, you're getting the training, the Facebook training system that has never been offered before with this package, only available here through our special thing, you know, because we hooked that up for you guys, and Ryan is so nice to bend over and say, yeah, let's help. but then also on top of that, being a private, I had to say that, Ryan. I just
take one for the team.
Take one for the team. But on top of that, it's a private Facebook group, which is on its own way more valuable than any of you can imagine, because it's like ongoing live case studies on a daily basis. I mean, it's really amazing what is all here beyond the tool. The tool itself stands on its own, like 10 times more valuable than what you're going to get it for here, but then everything else is just adding to it to make it a no-brainer to not be able to take this and succeed with this and be able to actually dig for that amazing treasure there in Facebook and do it easily and fast. And even beyond that, guys, if you're seeing those license options, look, I'll just recap that real quick as well, because I know some people get confused. Look, there's no limitation whether you get the one license, the unlimited license, or the light license, the unlimited license, or the three license. The difference is how many machines you can install them on. And Dan said it perfectly earlier. It's we always recommend that you plan ahead. And if you think you're going to at some point need it on more than three machines because your business is growing, you might want to give it access to outsourcers or other members of your team. Get the unlimited. But if you know you don't need that many, you get what's appropriate to you. But there's no limitation on usage of this amazing tool. So buy with confidence. We know this thing rocks. So there you go. There's your recap real quick.
Awesome.
Go to toRockstarsLike.com/SLF.
Awesome recap. I know Ali G has this story where one company bought 500 licenses. Is that something around there?
Yeah. I was it was pretty amazing. I mean, I was in Sweden about a month ago, and on a holiday, and woke up and had a great night before. Woke up with my girlfriend out there, and basically got an email from a company over here in New York. An advertising company for their approximate 500 employees. They wanted to close on the deal. They originally wanted me to do certain things and that, and I told them I'm traveling, I'm not going to be able to, and kind of dismissed what they wanted. They wanted these changes and whatnot done to the software. So I told them, listen, I can't do that right now. 4 days later, they contacted me. They're like, let's do this deal. We really want the software. We want about 500 licenses for all our employees. So I closed that deal. This is something that is not just for even large companies, I guess, are noticing what this software can do. And Ryan is one of the people that I actually, me and Ryan have gone way back, and I introduced him to the software when I was launching it. Before I even launched it, he had access to it, and he started using it and started developing all these techniques. So that's why I really wanted Ryan on this call, because and then me and Ryan worked out this special offer for everybody here. So, you know, this is really a real deal software solution. It's not going anywhere. Like I said, I'm Facebook compliant. I'm a developer. And as new features are available and new updates come out with the API, of course everybody here is going to get updated. This is going to be around for a while. Facebook is only growing. I mean, you could just look at the stock. I mean, the stock made a complete 180. And Zuckerberg never wanted to make friends. He just wanted to make billions of dollars.
That's cool. That's what he's going to get written on his tombstone.
Right? The guy who creates the largest social network is known to be very not social. So yeah, that's basically the story as far as what happened with that company. And yeah, it was great to close a deal like that when I'm traveling.
A huge company literally bought it for every single one of their employees. So if you guys aren't thinking about, you know, if one may not be enough, think about how, you know, even perhaps you want to hire on employees, you know, even if they're VAs or whatever, they're going to need access to the software. So you can outsource this, guys. You don't have to do all the scraping and, you know, figure out all the groups and all the interests. You can just outsource this with a VA. You know, show them the training that you get here. You know, give them access to the product, to the training, and, you know, make sure they can install it on their computer. But you can't do that unless you have 3 to 5 licenses. So if you're thinking of going that route, saving some extra time yourself and outsourcing it, you're going to want to pick up at least 3 licenses for that.
Agreed. There's some more good questions coming in here. Dan, would you look at those for me and bring those up?
I don't know which ones you guys have answered already because I tuned out for a second. Because
of course you did. Of course
handling
you did.
What you asked me to handle a minute ago.
Let's see.
Somebody did want to know if you can set different passwords for each license if you got the unlimited license. Can you set different passwords or logins?
No. It's the same login. But your login is connected to the license. So if you have the standard license, you're gonna be able to install it on 3 machines. If you have the pro license, and you know, I think somebody even asked me like, what if I give it to a client? As long as you have a trusting relationship with your client and they're, you know, an established client of yours, then yeah, sure. There's no problem if you wanted to share your login with your client. But again, you know, this is your login, so you just want to make sure who you're sharing it to. And what Ryan was hinting at earlier, you want to keep yourself maybe open to the possibility that your business will expand.
But let's reiterate that there is no limitation to use the tool. I mean, so if you got the 3, you know, computer license. And you have it installed on your laptop and your desktop, and then your significant other's computer as well, or your business partner's computer, whatever it may be. That's the only limitation. But you know, you can go in and abuse the hell out of this for your own awesome gain. So that's the only difference. And we always recommend, you know, go as big as you think you're going to go, because this is going to at least double in price pretty quickly. So, and then hell, in this deal here, you're getting this special coaching and training system that was never available before with this package. So that's reason enough. But hey, somebody is asking, I think it's been answered before, but I'll answer it one more time. How does this differ from other scraper tools? I will not name the tool that you named there, okay? But because that person is a dear friend of ours. The difference is, and I can't really compare it to that tool specifically, but the difference is, as far as I know, and Ollie, correct me if I'm wrong, this is the only tool that is 100% compliant, without a doubt, with all terms of service with Facebook. There's not some sort of exploit or loophole that it's taking advantage of to get all this amazing, you know, gold out of there. It's completely above board with everything that Facebook wants out of a development product that's attached to it, whereas the other tools there's some questions about, you know, whether or not at some point those loopholes can be closed and make those tools a little less easy to work with. Did that answer that question all right, Ollie, or can you answer it?
Oh, yeah, no, I mean, you pretty much did, and, you know, I know the tool that was mentioned, and there's been other tools out there that have been mentioned, and people even ask me, like, oh, you know, Ollie, why doesn't your software do what this does, or why doesn't it do what this does? I've always made sure to stick by the guidelines, and it's kind of like, you know, slow and steady wins the race because others were shut down, and meanwhile I am only growing because now more features are being implemented and allowed by the API, and everybody's going to get it. You know, and if there's other software that does things that are different than what my software does, you just got to keep in mind that I'm fully using the API. So if there is something that a tool is doing that my software doesn't do, most likely it is going against Facebook's terms of service, and there's a clock ticking on how long it'll take Facebook to catch on to it and then eventually shut them down. Cool. So that's basically the rundown as far as the software goes.
Yeah. And then okay, so the other question, this is a good question here, is all right, I guess this is somebody who arrived late. And for those who did arrive late, don't worry, we will get a replay up hopefully tonight, Dan, right?
Dan's working on the 8-track version.
Yeah, 8-track version. But no, but for some of you who arrived late, the question is, with this, you know, once they get in, once I get in this, how long is it until I can start doing this stuff? Is there a learning curve? Guys, no. I mean, honestly, even before, I mean, if you look at the way I do things, I buy something and I just dig right into it without reading the manual. but the thing is, with this tool, once you get this, I mean, by tonight, you'll have your first campaigns going. You'll be able to start seeing and testing things and getting results that you probably struggled to get before, and at least have very quick feedback on what's right, what's not working, what you can do better, and it's only cost you a few bucks to do that. And so what I'm saying here is, you get this right now, before you go to bed tonight, you're already going to have action taken that's going to be moving you that much closer to picking up some income that you hadn't been able to tap into before.
Okay, yeah, there's another question here. Remember, everybody, you got to remember that my software here is not a scraper. Somebody asked when we scrape the leads, do we do it through our own Facebook account? You are logging through your own Facebook account, but I would never do something to jeopardize anybody's account here. Scraping is strictly against Facebook's terms of service. What we're doing is basically retrieving data that is through the Facebook API that's allowed by Facebook.
Yeah, so there's no way for your account to be shut down if you use the tool. You know, there's nothing that you need to do on your end to worry about it. And then, of course, the software will be around for a long time because everything is 100% compliant. So any questions like that, yeah, we're definitely taking care of you on that end.
Exactly. Let's see, is it connected to my Facebook profile? Can this be changed if required? Well, yeah, I mean, you log in through your own Facebook account. Depending on your network, your friends or friends and things like that, it also opens you up to different abilities of how many user IDs you can pull and things like that, because it is connected to your network. So if you have a vast network, like if you have thousands of friends, then the possibilities are really endless. I mean, it really opens you up to a lot of things. You got to remember that Facebook, this software does respect privacy settings that people have set forth. So but all in all, the larger your network and you use your own Facebook account, that's the best way to go about it.
Yep. And okay, good question here. Do they need to create a Facebook group? No, you don't need to. That's just one of the avenues in which you can draw traffic into. Just like what we showed some of you who are fortunate enough to get in on our landlord method. That's one of the great ways of drawing in and building up an asset. But look, guys, you can send them straight to a targeted offer that makes sense. You can't just say, hey, here's an ad, pay me $10,000. That's probably not going to work very well for you. You have to treat this like a funnel. I mean, you're trying to attract leads to take a step towards you and still building a relationship from there. But what you're doing is you're able to get the leads to come to you, which eliminates a lot of the BS. And whether you're doing it for a client, on behalf of a client to get them leads, or for yourself to get your own business or your own consulting leads, that's all there is to it. So you just draw them any offer that's appropriate to that. But the hard part has always been tapping into the right markets, the right audiences, and doing it with ease. And that takes all that mess out of it with this tool. It's all done for you, all the hard stuff. So that's what makes it so cool. And then somebody is asking a good question, Ollie. I'll let you answer. Is this connected to their Facebook profile? If so, can it be changed if required?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's connected to your Facebook profile because when you first, because you got to remember, I'm a Facebook app developer. My social Lead Freak is, in essence, an extension of a Facebook application. So when you first, you know, when you first install Facebook, it's going to say, "Oh, this is an application." You say yes, and then that's it, and then you you are connected. Can this be changed down the road? Absolutely. Whatever Facebook account you want to log in with, you can change and have it accordingly. You can try it with different Facebook accounts, you know, try it with your friend's account, you know, whatever you want to do. It's entirely up to you.
Yep, absolutely. Oh, Dale has a question. Will our two favorite rock stars be doing any special training with this product? Well, I thought we just did. Don't be surprised if we do. I definitely see us doing that because this thing has been a game changer for us. So I imagine since this has become a big part of our arsenal, we will keep sharing as we keep doing more amazing things faster and easier with what you got here. It's awesome. Thanks for the question, Dale.
And just to add in, you know, I was talking about the sales funnel. There's different levels of what a lead is. On Facebook, you have likes. You know, they can like your page, they can like your posts. You know, that's pretty good. That's a good start, right? You're not gonna get a whole lot of results from that because likely they probably won't ever come back to that page. There's an 18% chance that they will, though. But then there's the leads. So you want to do a promoted post to take advantage of both likes and leads. So you want to send them eventually off to your website or a landing page, or even if it's a landing page on Facebook, you can keep them on Facebook as well. So they have a lot of options there, but basically the process, you take likes, you convert them to leads, and you convert them to customers.
Yeah, and you want to know another little cool thing here, guys, that we've been doing more and more of, and it's become a part of our main strategy, both online and offline. And I might be getting a little too technical, so if I am, please, I'm not going to go too far into it because it can be its own whole course. But guys, once you draw those leads in, if you're taking them out of Facebook, like for example, to your WordPress page that might be have an opt-in or an offer or a webinar registration, any whatever you're doing, install that freaking tracking code and retarget them, because then you can take that and create an alternate campaign that's even cheaper, just based on who's cookied in, who's landed on your site or your offer already, and you have a completely different message because you can have an assumptive message knowing that they've already seen your offer, they've already seen it. So you can have a completely different message saying, hey, you know, you saw this, that, you know, did you take advantage of this thing? And so that's, I mean, that's another way of just like, you know, taking, you know, like after all that, you know, when mom makes the cake and lets you have the cake batter in there, and you take that finger and you like, you know, slide it down there to get that last bit of cake batter in the bottom of the pan. I mean, that's what that's doing. It's that retargeting stuff. And man, when you do this for a client or another entity, they think it's like a freaking magic trick. They're like, wow. So everybody who lands on my auto mechanic website later on, they're gonna see an ad on their Facebook, you know, when they're logged into Facebook, that, you know, showing it. So I mean, it's just really cool. It's just it goes another step beyond to brand a business and just have that top of mind mentality. So that's just another of many ways. That's why we love Facebook so much, and that's why we're not really doing a whole lot on other social platforms. I mean, we know Twitter's there, we know LinkedIn's there, so on and so forth, and those are all great. They all have their own place. But man, when it comes to this stuff, this is like the Wild West, and those who understand the principles of marketing, even just to a small degree, can just dominate with this stuff because it's all out there. And you know, this being the only tool that's fully you know, on the up and up with all the API with Facebook, it just makes it so easy to take advantage of all that and really enjoy it. That's what I love about it.
Yeah, and another thing I just want to point out there, I know we've been talking about Facebook a lot, but you know, this is kind of like the black sheep here, I guess. Google Plus, it also searches Google Plus too. So you know, we didn't even hit on that at all. Google Plus is a totally different setup. They don't have the same things as Facebook does, but you could also search Google Plus if you wanted to with the activities tab. So that searches Google Plus for you.
Awesome.
I created a problem now because our good friend here, Dan, the other Dan, not Dr. Dan, is asking, is that retargeting training covered? No, that was kind of my little special thing I added in there. for we just
it's covered for members who buy.
Yeah, it is. So yeah.
Yeah,
there you go.
So yeah, with Ryan's you know training that he's going to be you know he's given this as a bonus for everyone that gets involved here. Yeah, you will have that retargeting training, which is huge.
Awesome. There's a couple of really good questions here. Very common questions that I've been asked quite a bit. Do you ever use CPM, which is cost per 1,000 impressions, on Facebook? I rarely do because what you'll end up happening is cost per click will get you a much better placement, and you'll get more results that way. So they'll put you like in the A spot, let's say, you know, if you're thinking like an AdWords campaign. So cost per click gets you higher priority compared to CPM. And you'll end up paying around the same amount. The only case you want to do that is if you really have a very, very high click-through rate. So if you have something that's really hot, you're getting like 10, 20% click-through rate, then the CPM is definitely something you're going to want to run. So that's usually for like a likes campaign or just a really, really awesome promoted post that you put together for a small audience. But in most cases, click CPC, which is... cost per click is highly recommended, and you'll know exactly how much you're going to pay.
Yep, exactly. Let's see, what else we got here? Any other questions?
One or two more questions. Do you see anything there, Dan?
I think the only ones that I saw were the ones asking about the retargeting.
I think we pretty much hit on everything. On the realtors, let's see.
How is Ryan's retargeting training bonus accessed?
Oh yeah, so let's talk about that for a second because let's talk about that for a second because when you guys buy with our link, this is a special bonus that's only available here through the Rockstars. So A, make sure that like you don't have any like cookie blockers or anything like that on your browser because it will automatically figure out that you got it through our link, and when you go through JVZoo to pick it up, you'll be able to access it there through JVZoo, and it'll be right there in the bonuses. So that's how you'll access it. So you know they'll be really easy to get to. You'll just have to log into JVZoo to access your product there, and then you'll see the bonuses there in that folder, and they'll be right there. So that's why I say make sure like if you get it, you know, make sure you get it from the link we provided here, because otherwise you won't get it.
Exactly.
All right. So.
Yeah, no, that's it.
Yeah, we've gone longer than we were intending.
That's so much for a 45-minute webinar, guys. But we love you guys, and we see that most of you have stuck around the whole time, so we appreciate you guys coming, hanging with us, learning some new cool stuff with Facebook. And really, the most important thing you can do is one way or another, take advantage of what Facebook is putting right in front of you. Starting today, I mean, go through and take a serious effort to start generating leads for yourself, for your clients, because what's out there already is money that's waiting for somebody to grab. And that can be you, it could be somebody else. I mean, it's up to you, and you don't have to do it the hard way. There, like we just showed you, there's an easy way, and there's all kinds of training, and there's a whole support group behind this that's only available here. So if you have not yet gone to tworockstarslike.com/SLF, don't delay, because I really don't want you to be one of the people that we get those mini help desk tickets saying, I'm sorry I didn't get in on time, can you hook me up? And then we're like, no, we can't, sorry. And then we look like a bunch of assholes. So don't make me look like an asshole. Go get it right now. Okay. But yeah, that's all I got to say. Anything to add, Dan, Ollie, Ryan?
Let's see. I think we covered. Ryan, what do you think?
Yeah,
Ryan,
I think we gave out way too much information.
what I just wanted to put in there was like it's always really cool to hear your clients get excited about how their customer came in and said that you know their ad was all up on Facebook and they were just compelled to click it. So you know it's like. When they see that and when they hear that, now they're just in a marketplace that they didn't even know that they could be part of. And it's like it creates an excitement factor, and I think it really helps in the retention of the clients. So you can, you know, book clients month after month after month, or even have like a retainer for a set amount of time, because they, you know, a lot of these clients get really excited. They feel like they're in a whole new world that everybody uses. Everybody is on their phones, on Facebook. You know, when people are in an elevator, people for some reason think it's awkward and they all go on Facebook. I've always seen that in elevators. I don't know why. You know, so,
you know, you're at a lot of elevators in New York City, so you'll be
seeing that. Yeah, it's always the case. I'm like, oh, great, everybody's on Facebook. Oh, hi, you know, but yeah, it's really refreshing, and I think it really helps your business when you hear your clients say that, you know. So it's a good feeling. That's what I just want to put out there.
Cool. So if we all want to spam Ali G after this webinar with an advertisement to him. You know, take this number right here, write this down, put that into a custom audience, and, you know, try to set up the best advertisement will win an iPad or something. You're going to give something out of giveaway.
My sister's number? Oh, man.
Well, there you go. Yeah, the best advertisement wins the number.
The best pickup line.
Oh man, yeah. I'm sure that's never been given away on a webinar.
Send your selfie. Send a selfie to Ali G.
So this is how you do it. You get a whole list of these numbers. You import them to Facebook. Then you can start running ads right to them. You can do as little as one, as you can see right here. I have the Ali G custom audience loaded up.
Yeah, custom audience of one. So your ad campaign only targets me.
Yeah. So I know I won't be paying a whole lot.
Watch so many of these people go on there and do it that the ads actually become expensive.
Oh, Ali G. Oh no, I gotta pay $3 per click. Target Ali G.
Screw that. Screw that. $3 a click. All right, guys. Like I said, if you haven't gone to tworockstarslike.com/SLF, go do it right now. You're gonna love this. It's going to make life so much easier. If you haven't already tapped into Facebook, this is the perfect leaping board for it. So, and if you already have tapped in, this is going to make it so much easier to leverage everything you already know and are already doing. This is awesome. Get it. Rock on with it. And guys, thanks for coming and hanging with us. For everybody, Ollie, Ryan, Doc, all of our good fans out there, we love you, and we will see you on the next Rockstar webinar.
Thank you very much. Great to be here.
Thank you, guys.
Awesome. Yeah, you're welcome. Thanks, guys. Be a rockstar in your business and in your life. And rock on.
And rock on.